تبسم 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 تبسم
تبسم تبسم وخل الهموم وخل الغموم وخل الضجر ولا تبتئس من صروف الزمان ولا تشتكي من طعون البشر.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيد المرسلين سيدنا محمد خير خلق الله، من أرسله الله رحمة للعالمين، وقال الله في حقه وما أرسلناك إلا رحمة للعالمين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحابته ومن اهتدى بهديه واستنى بسنته إلى يوم الدين. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته.
وعليكم السلام.
My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, we are very honored to be here in this mosque to visit our brothers and sisters in Islam to pray Salatul Jum'ah with you. The Jum'ah is very important ibadah in Islam. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Al-Jum'atu lil-Jum'ati kaffaratun lima baynahuma idha tunibat al-kaba'ir." He said, "Jum'ah to Jum'ah will erase all the sins that you have done if you avoid the big sins." And the ulama, they said the Jum'ah is for the poor people, it's like a Hajj for them. They narrated from Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu, he said, "Whoever live Jum'ah three Jum'ah, he throw Islam behind him." In another hadith he said, "Man taraka thalatha jum'ah mutawaliyatin faqad nabadha al-Islam wara'a dhahri." Wa man taraka thalatha jum'ah mutawaliyatin faqad nabadha al-Islam wara'a dhahri. So we have to encourage our people to hold Salawat al-Khams, first of all, but practically Jum'ah time. Because Salat is the biggest ibadah that all the angels, the ibadah, each one of them, they have one of part of Salat. Some of them, they making tisbih. Some of them, they standing glorifying Allah. Some of them, they making ruku. Some of them, they making sujood. Some of them, they sitting. But as the ummah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Allah give us all this type of the way of salat, and we have it in one salat. When we making salat, we standing, we read Quran, we make ruku, we make tasbih, we make sujood, we sitting, all this we include in our salat, all the way of salat of malaika. And all the five pillars of Islam, you can find it when you pray. Because the first pillar of Islam is shahadatu an la ilaha illallah wa anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. Of course, when you make salat, you make tashahud. Hajj, the meaning of Hajj, qasdu baytillah al-haram, to go to the house of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, to face the Kaaba. When you're making salat, you're facing the Kaaba. It's like in your salat, you making tashahud, but you're making Hajj in the same time. When you're making salat, you look like you fasting, because it's not possible for you when you're making salat to drink anything or to eat anything. While you are in salat, you are in sawm. Before you make salat, you make wudu, and wudu is you buy it, it's money. It's like you give in zakat before you make salat. That's why salat is very important ibadah in Islam. Salatu imaduddin. Faman aqamaha faqad aqama ad-din wa man hadamaha faqad hadama ad-din. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said salat is the pillars of deen. If you keep it straight, you keep your deen straight. If you destroy it, you destroy your deen. Inna salata tanha 'anil fahsha'i wal munkar. Quran said as-salat will take you away from doing bad things and doing unlawful things. That's why whenever you see somebody praying and still doing the bad things, that means he didn't pray the proper way. Because we have to give our time when we're praying. We do it the proper way. Because Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he saw somebody was praying. He said, go make salat, you didn't pray. He prayed again, he said, go make salat again, you didn't pray. He prayed again, he said, go make salat again, you didn't pray. And he said, I don't know, except this what I know. And Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam teach him, when you want to pray, you have to stand up and make ihram and make itminan. Don't move until after that you read your Fatiha, you read the surah, and you come back from the ruku, and you stay a little bit, then go to sujood, and he teach him how to pray. So when Allah said the salat will take you away from doing bad things, that is true. So the closest way to reach to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala is salat. That's why Allah make it the highest pillars in this deen. Even the people in hellfire, when they ask them, ma salakakum fi saqar, qalu lam nakum min al-musallin. What put you in hellfire? He said, we weren't among the musallin, the people who praying. So when you hear lam nakum min al-musallin, among the people praying, that means also when you pray you have to be with people. Salat al-jama'a. If you don't have any excuse, you have to do your best to make salat with jama'a. Because in Fatiha, look in Fatiha, when you say Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, Rahman al-Rahim, Maliki Yawmiddin, Iyaka na'budu wa iyaka nasta'in. When you get to that, only you we worship. Only from you we look for help. Because we shouldn't worship anybody except Allah. We shouldn't look help from anybody except Allah. But when you say that, Allah say, Hadha bayni wa bayna abdi wa li abdi ma sa'al. This is between me and my servant. Whatever my servant asks me, I give it to him. What did you ask? Allah didn't let you ask anything. Because if he said that and let you ask, maybe you ask something you think that is important, but it's not. But he teach you what you should ask. When he said, whatever you ask me, I give you, he teach you what you should ask him. What did you ask? Iyyaka na'budu wa iyyaka nasta'in. You said, ihdina sirat al-mustaqim. Oh Allah, guide us to the right path. To show you how is hidayah is more important than any other things that you're looking for. Of course, in your salat, you can ask after that whatever you want. After your salat, you can ask whatever you want. But the point that is, when Allah said, this between me and my servant, what did he ask me I give to him? He teach you to ask him to guide you to the right path. That to show you that to be in the right path is very important. It's very important because whenever we pray 5 daily prayers, every day we pray, we will do 17 rakah. Each rakah, what we ask Allah for is ihdina sirat al-mustaqim. To ask Allah to help us to stay in the right path. The right path is the path of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Thus, Allah be mercy with them. أولئك الذين أنعم الله عليهم من النبيين والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين وحسن أولئك رفيقا. That's the path of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and all the Prophet and the Siddiqeen and the Shuhada and the good people. Whenever they say good people, they are the people who do the farida and nafila. والعصر إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر. Allah said, all mankind are losers except those who believe in Allah and do the good things. Amanu wa amilu salihati, they are the people who do the farida and do the nafila, extra good work. Watawasaw bil haqqi, watawasaw bil sabr, and they advise each other for truth, and they advise each other to be patient. The Muslim, we have to advise each other for the sake of Allah, because nasiha is the part of iman. Ad-deenu nasiha. Ad-deen is advice. Qalu liman ya Rasulullah, qala lillahi wa li rasulihi wa li aimmatil muslimin wa li kitabihi wa li aimmatil muslimin wa ammatihim. We have to advise our brother whenever we see them in the right path, we encourage them. When we see them in the wrong way, we have to advise them. As what Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, unsur akhaka zaliman aw mazluman, help your brother, either he's right or he's wrong. And the sahaba said, we know how to help our brother if he's right, but how to help our brother if he's wrong? He said, to ask him to stop doing the wrong things. Ihdina as-sirat al-mustaqim, I said, when we ask Allah to guide us to the right way, the way of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you didn't say ihdini, guide me, to show you that you have to pray with congregation, because you say ihdina, guide us, to show you that we have to pray with congregation if we don't have any excuse. Allah said, "Warka'u ma'arraki'in," make ruku with the people. Make ruku means make salat. Warka'u ma'arraki'in. When you pray alone, you will have one reward. If you pray with congregation, salatul jama'ati afdalu min salatil fardi bi 27 daraja. In another hadith, salat al-jama'ati afdalu min salat al-fardi bi 25 daraja. If you have a business here, and you know, if you sell it, here they pay you 1,000 rand, and you know, if you go to Durban, they pay you 27,000, of course you will go to Durban. Even if you can't go to Cape Town, you go to Cape Town. Sometimes you can even fly outside the country to just have more. And if you know that Salat al-Jama'ah, you have more reward. We have to do our best to do Salat al-Jama'ah with our Jama'ah, with our congregation. Because the Masjid in time of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, all the problems of the Muslim, they solve it when they come to the Masjid. It's the school. In our Masjid we pray. In our Masjid we help each other. In our Masjid we study. Like when one time Abu Hurairah came to the market, And when he saw people, he told them, "You are here." And people are there in the mosque and distribute the inheritance of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And everybody leave the market and go to the mosque. When they come to the mosque, they don't find anything distributing. They just find us, what we're doing now, making zikr, teaching, making salat, and they come back to Abu Hurairah. They say, "We go to the mosque, but we didn't see anything there. We just found people who praying, people mentioning Allah, people studying." He said, "That is the inheritance of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is the legacy of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam." Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "نحن معاشر الأنبياء لا نورث دينارا ولا درهما ولكن نورث علما من أخذ به فقد أخذ بحظ وافر." He said, "We are the people of the Anbiya of Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala. We don't leave behind us money, dinar or dirham, dollar or euro, but what we leave behind us is this knowledge. Whoever take from it, he take big part from us." So I said, "Ihdina sirat al-mustaqima," to follow the way of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sirat al-lazina an'amta alayhim. One Sahaba came to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and asked him. He said, "The work of Islam is too many. I want you to just give me short things that I can keep and use it." And Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Qul amantu billahi thumma istaqim." Said, "I believe in Allah and you be in the right path." The ulama of Tazkiyah, they said, to be in the right path, the right path is Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Right path is Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You have to love him more than you love yourself. You have to follow him, as what he said, "Kullukum yadkhulu al-janna illa man aba." Qalu, "Wa man ya'ba ya Rasulullah?" Qala, "Man ata'ani dakhala al-jannata wa man 'asani faqad aba." He said, "All of you will enter to paradise, except somebody who doesn't like to go to paradise." They say, "Who doesn't like to go to paradise?" He said, "Whoever follow me, he love to go to paradise. Who doesn't follow me, he dislike to go to paradise." So the way of paradise is to follow the way of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. To fight our nafs, to follow the way of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. As what sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Huffatil jannatu bil makarihi wa huffatil naru bil shahawat." He said, all what is surrounding the paradise is what the nafs doesn't like, but all surrounding the hellfire is what your nafs likes. So for you to go to paradise, you have to fight your nafs, to follow Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, to follow him the way of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You don't follow Allah the way you like. You follow Allah the way Allah is like. "Inna Allah la yu'budu bi muhassanati al-uqul." You can't worship Allah from what your mind give you, but you worship Allah from what Allah ask you to do. And all what Allah ask us to do, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam brought it to us. Atiyu Allah wa atiyu Rasul. Follow Allah, follow his Prophet. وَمَنْ يُطِعِ الرَّسُولَ فَقَدْ أَطَاعَ اللَّهَ. Whoever follow the Prophet, he follow Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Allah said, "لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ لِمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُو اللَّهَ وَالْيَوْمَ الْآخِرَ وَذَكَرَ اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا." You have best examples in Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But that example is for those who believe in Allah and believe in the last day and mention Allah a lot. Prophet is example for everybody, but not everybody can take him as examples. Like Quran is hidayah, is guidance for everybody, but not everybody can get the guidance from Quran. That's why when Allah said, "وَبَيِّنَاتٍ مِنَ الْهُدَى وَالْفُرْقَانِ," he said, "Hudan linnasi," Allah said, Quran is guidance for everybody, all human beings. But in Surah Al-Baqarah, ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابُ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ هُدًى لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. He says guidance for those who fear Allah. So it's example that Allah brought it for everybody, but only people who have taqwa, they can use it to reach Allah to Barak wa Ta'ala. And whenever we say taqwa, is to follow the order of Allah to Barak wa Ta'ala. When Allah said do, you do it. When Allah says stop, you stop. That is taqwa Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. That maqam will come after iman billahi tabarak wa ta'ala. Because when Allah said, ya ayyuhallazina amanu taqullaha, who you believe in Allah, fear Allah. So iman will come, then taqwa come after that. Because iman, you have it in your heart, but taqwa will come with your actions. Because, you know, some sahaba, they die before they confirm all this prayers of Islam, and they die with iman. Those people, they go to paradise, because some of them, they die before Allah makes salat obligation. Some of them, they die before Sawm, to fast, because Allah makes Sawm obligation 2 years after Hijrah. Some of them, they die before Allah has make Hajj obligation, because some of the ulama, they say Allah makes Hajj obligation 6 years after Hijrah, but most of them, they said 9 years after Hijrah, that Allah make Hajj obligation. You know, many sahaba, they die with the iman and without using all this ibadat. But they have the iman in their heart, that iman is sufficient for them to go to paradise. But after Allah make all this ibadat obligation, just iman is not enough for you. Because iman, you have to mention it in your tongue, have it in your heart, but use it in your actions. That is complete iman billahi tabarak wa ta'ala. That is, you be among the muttaqin who fear Allah. And if you fear Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, that is opening for you. Whatever you want, if you have taqwa, Allah will open that for you. If you want your heart to be clean and to know what is wrong and what is right, have taqwa. وَمَنْ يَتَّقِ اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ فُرْقَانًا. Who يَتَّقُ اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَكُمْ فُرْقَانًا. If you fear Allah, Allah will make furqan in your heart, that you can make distinction between what is good and what is bad. Even before anybody tell you, what Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, what your nafs ask you, ask your heart. And if the heart is clean, if you ask the heart, will tell you the right directions. That's why he said, وَاتَّقُوا فِرَاسَةَ الْمُؤْمِنِ فَإِنَّهُ يَنْظُرُ مِنْ نُورِ اللَّهِ. He said, the believer, he will look with the light of Allah تبارك وتعالى. That light will come when you fear Allah تبارك وتعالى. If you fear Allah تبارك وتعالى, if you need knowledge, fear Allah. وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَيُعَلِّمُكُمُ اللَّهِ. Allah بكل شيء عليم. Fear Allah, then Allah will teach you, and Allah is all knowing. If you just take your knowledge from the book or from your sheikh, your knowledge can be limited. Only what you see from the book, that what you can have. What your teacher tell you, that what you can have. But if you fear Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, Allah will put light in your heart, that you know what is good and what is bad. If you want to be among the awliya of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, you fear Allah. They are like everybody, but the differences between them and people is just fearing Allah. Ala inna awliya Allahi la khawfun alayhim wa la yahzanun alladhina amanu wa kanu yattaqun. So those who believe in Allah and fear Allah, those, they are the friend of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Everybody looking for good friends. But this is your key for Allah to be your friend, to fear Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Allah will be your friend. If Allah be your friend, it will guide you, of course, to the way of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He will guide you to the way of paradise. You will have good ending, as what Allah said in Quran. If you afraid your enemy, you fear Allah. Allah will teach you. So what we need to increase our iman with our good deed. We need to increase our taqwa Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, to follow the way of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. The problem of this ummah now is just many people, they claim that they are among the ummah, but they fight the ummah. But the hadith that this little girl just mentioned, if we use that, we can help. That will help. One sahaba came to Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He said, "Awsimi." Sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "La taghdab." Don't be angry. He said, "Awsini." He said, "Don't be angry." He said, "Awsini." He said, "Don't be angry." So, because angry is from shaitan. So whatever comes from shaitan is no good for you. Inna shaitan lakum adun fattakhidhu adwa. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala said, shaitan is your enemy. Consider it, consider him as your enemy. But what do you think if people take shaitan now as a good friend, always he will guide them to the bad way. That is what is calling people now to do all these things, to kill innocent people, to do bad things in the name of Islam. If we have real iman, because even take harm from the way, even the boy just read it, imatatul adha ani tariq sadaqa, is sadaqa, but it's not just sadaqa, but it's part of iman. In another hadith, الإيمان ست وسبعون بدء وسبعون شعبة أعلاها لا إله إلا الله وأدناها إماتة الأذى عن الطريق. He say iman is 60 something branch. The highest branch is لا إله إلا الله. We say لا إله إلا الله to renew our iman. But أدناها, the lowest, is to take arm from the way of people. Even take anything that will can harm people in their way is part of iman. So this is the beauty of our religion, is you have connection with Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, but you have to be nice with your family, your neighbor, your brother. You be nice for all human beings, because our deen is deen rahmah. وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. We send you for nothing except to be mercy for all the world. So the action of Muslim should show that our deen is deen of mercy. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم.
تبسم تبسم وخل الهموم وخل الغموم وخل الضجر.